Just love Rob Mills. Yes. From when he launched into the showbiz world thanks to Australian Idol, throughout his stage career and a role on Neighbours. We've all felt we knew Millsy, the real Millsy, but at some times it was just an act.
Rob Mills has written a book about manhood, mates and mental health.
Yes.
And is encouraging men to drop the act and talk about their mental health. The book is called Putting on a Show, and Millsy joins us right now. Am I still allowed to call you Millsy?
Yeah,
Millsy.
Come on. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Big studio audience in today. It's good. Thanks, crew.
It's been a long time since those Australian Idol days. How do you feel about still always being known as Australian Idol? Is that okay?
I feel great. It's part of my, part of who I am. Mm. I mean, for a lot of the public, they grew up watching me grow up, I suppose. I was 21 back then, so wow. I'm now just turned 40 this year.
You look great.
Yeah, thanks, mate. You too.
You actually look better every time I see you. It's not fair. It's not fair.
Many observations to make about life,
yes.
And you've written about a lot of it here. Has it been a bit confronting for you to write some of the things that you've
Yeah, like, it was probably more memoir than I thought it was going to be. So the whole idea was to sort of look at what is the Aussie bloke? Who is he?
Mm.
What is these sort of stereotypical Aussie blokes that we grew up with in the 60s, 70s? There's the beach blonde Bondi surfer. There's the outback cracking the whip kind of sheep shearing Jackie Howe wearing bloke. I'm not that guy. You're not that guy.
Who's the guy on the cover then?
He's the business on the top and the party down the bottom, you know?
Beautiful.
I also love with the cover as well. We went with a cup of tea instead of a beer. Or it's just a cup. It could be maybe there's a bit of something special in there. So it's up to you how you sort of see that bloke.
Love it.
But so I wanted to find out, investigate this, and who better to do that than the help of people who have been working in this field. So Dr. Pat McGorry, Professor Jane Perkis, Tommy Harkin, who runs empowering workshops for young men and for corporates, Tyson Younger-Porter, who's an Indigenous lecturer and author. He's fantastic. A sexologist named Georgia Grace, Jamila Rizvi, she's an incredible author. And, yeah, so there's the voices of many of these people that I've met along the journey. Reverend Bill Cruz, I got to speak to. My friend Kirk Docker, who created You Can't Ask That for the ABC, who's interviewed every version of the Australian bloke, I think, that there is. So, yeah, it's their voices. I'm trying to shine a light on all the things that they've discovered as well, and also trying to learn along with the reader. That's the sort of plan of it, yeah.
Mate, you get very open, honest. I mean, Tony Armstrong's even quoted you, raw, honest and funny. But when you were being so raw, you had two friends die in recent years. Mental health is huge in this country, especially for young men.
Yeah.
I guess, firstly, how did that impact you and did it inspire you during the book?
Look, I lost a couple of mates to cancer during the lockdown when we were not allowed to cross borders, when we were allowed to go into hospitals, weren't allowed to go to funerals, like so many people across the country. It was a horrible, horrible time. I think when the lockdowns finished, I went out drinking with mates and I found that drinking doesn't actually make it better.
No.
It actually makes you feel a lot worse. So I had a good look at my relationship with alcohol. I think as everyone does as they get older.
Mm.
And I realised that maybe I don't need to do it as much why am I languishing? There's a great article in the Washington Post came out last year or the year before about this sense that no one was really thriving and no one was sort of failing completely. They're just sort of languishing. And I felt like that's kind of like what we were all doing and I was experiencing. I just wanted to, try and... Are there many other blokes that were doing that? It turns out there were and there are.
So it's all about being a healthy masculine, I guess, isn't it? And all the ways that you can do it and all the experts that you talk to, who I'm sure you've become friends with.
Yeah.
Is your healthy masculine going to be on show during the Melbourne Cup?
I hope so. I mean, during the Melbourne Cup Carnival, working again with the wonderful team at Channel 10, I can't wait. I mean, it's one of my favourite things is to dress up just in a suit. Mm. You know, a guy who gets around in active wear for a couple of years, so... It's nice to be able to dress up. I'm looking forward to the coverage. We've got a very good team. My lovely partner.
You and Georgie?
Georgie's working. Yes. Archie Thompson, Tara Rushton.
Wow.
Oh, look at the two of you. Beautiful. Oh, she's your fiancée, Georgie.
She's pretty cute. Yeah, very, very cute there. We're doing all right. Things are progressing well. She's back on 10 now, working on the project full time.
Very good. She does a wonderful job.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
You're going to look sensational come Cup Carnival time.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Hey, mate, thank you so much for joining us. Rob Mills' book, Putting on a Show, is out now. Rob Mills, you're a superstar,
mate. You're an entertainer.
Thank you. And remember, if anyone out there needs help, Lifeline is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on 131114. Good job, buddy.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you,
guys.
Millsy, and thank you for writing this. This is going to be a fantastic tool for heaps of people.